Slack is a platform that allows users to communicate by sending messages, video chatting, sharing files and links within a designated space or a channel. Let's say I created a channel for a final project. Then I can communicate with everyone who's working on this specific project with me in this channel. I can send messages, react or comment to others' messages, or pin the message if it's important. For example, this Google Doc here looks very important, so I might want to pin it so that it's easier to find. I can also search any files that have been shared within the channel easily. Slack is used by many companies worldwide and less regarded as an edtech tool. I think if used properly, it can make some improvements for instructions and learning. However, I do believe there are reasons why it is less commonly used in a classroom. First of all, Slack is not a compliant of COPPA or FERPA, and it clearly states that it is not directed for those under 16 years old. Next, in my opinion, the navigation of Slack isn't that clear and simple. There are many functions and tabs, and it can take some efforts to get familiar with. To solve this problem, Slack has lots of resources like blogs and Help Center where you can find instructions and tips, but as a teacher, I would prefer a simpler tool with less distraction. Another important thing to consider is privacy. Slack does a fair job in making the privacy terms organized and thus clear. But if you are using its highlight function, which allows you to integrate external tools and services, you are giving Slack and the third-party tool the access to lots of your information, including your activities on Slack, your log information, location, etc. Last but not least, accessibility is limited to a certain group of people. On their website, I did not find the accessibility terms, and important functions like text messaging and file searching rely on typing, while voice input or voice over are not directly embedded on this platform.